Airway hyperresponsiveness, known as AHR for short, is a characteristic feature of asthma, describing a predisposition of the airways to narrow excessively when exposed to a stimulus that would cause no effect in a healthy individual. AHR exists on a spectrum of severity between individuals, and even within the same individual. There appears to be multiple factors which cause AHR in nearly all patients with asthma, with the severity of asthma being correlated to the severity of AHR. In other words, people with more severe asthma experience more severe AHR and vice versa. It might be helpful to envision three levels of categorization: genetic predisposition or environmental exposure to sensitizing factors and stimuli such as allergens, viruses, or mutations in occupational sensitizers like chemical agents; transient or episodic AHR, which is marked by instances of active inflammation; and finally, persistent AHR, which is marked by structural changes to the airway. Allergic responses are mediated by IgE. IgE is a type of antibody involved in allergic or atopic reactions. Antibodies are proteins in the body which recognize and neutralize foreign substances. Allergic responses mediated by IgE are the most common inducers of AHR, and the majority of asthmatic patients are atopic, meaning they are sensitive to these foreign substances, known as allergens. Many of the molecules which cells use to communicate with each other, broadly named cytokines, fall under a subclass called interleukins. This name refers to the involvement of white blood cells in their communication between each other, IL for short. IgE-induced AHR from an allergic atopic stimulus causes the production and mobilization of various cytokines, namely IL-4, IL-5, and IL-13, among many others. Monoclonal antibodies, which we will explore in our video on treatments in further depth, are proteins that can neutralize other proteins and are very useful in the treatment of IgE-mediated AHR. Many treatment options involve the inhibition of IgE with monoclonal antibodies such as anti-IgE. IgE-mediated AHR leads to the recruitment of eosinophils, a type of white blood cell. Thus, the presence of eosinophils in the airway can clue clinicians in that this may be IgE-mediated AHR. This can be identified by something called a sputum analysis, which is explained in detail in our video on sputum analysis. Since this type of temporary AHR is associated with inflammation, anti-inflammatory cytokines such as IL-12 and inhaled corticosteroids are often used to inhibit and treat allergen-mediated or allergen-induced AHR. Persistent AHR, on the other hand, may be caused by prolonged inflammation from instances of short-term AHR, but are mainly characterized by chronic and generally irreversible structural changes that develop secondary to chronic or prolonged airway inflammation, also known as airway remodeling. This persistent AHR is not particularly responsive to typical anti-inflammatory treatments such as inhaled corticosteroids or environmental control that would be effective for allergen-induced AHR. This is because persistent AHR is better defined by AHR to direct-acting stimuli such as methacholine and histamine. Airway remodeling involves increases in airway wall thickness from increased deposition of collagen, growth of the airway smooth muscle, and increased blood flow. Due to an increase in the muscle mass of airway smooth muscle, it is possible that increased contractility and sensitization to substances which usually trigger muscle constriction of the airway exacerbate the symptoms in persistent AHR. In conclusion, airway hyperresponsiveness is a condition that starts off with sensitizing factors or genetic predisposition and can present itself transiently or as a persistent condition.